4x4 TV, the television show for back road enthusiasts and backcountry adventurers.
You want to ride the Screaming Aardvark Trail this weekend?
You're on! I gotta get some gear though.
Yeah, me too. Hey, I'll see you then. Oh, cool.
What?
Yeah, I need a shot. So if I add the boots, shipping's free?
The shipping's free.
Excellent.
Oh, yes.
There's a package there.
Oh, yeah! My boots! Nice!
You look good.
Shut up.
Get ready the easy way with Rocky Mountain.
Terra Firma just got tamed. Introducing the TerraCross radio from ITP. It's built for maximum traction on hard-packed trails. The radial design gives you a smooth ride over any kind of terrain. Call for a free catalog or visit itptires.com.
For many years, there have been big trucks and then the Japanese trucks. Now, even though Toyota has attempted several times before to tackle the big three with a real big truck in the T100 and more recently with the previous generation Tundra, they really haven't quite been able to make the inroads into the big truck market like they have in every other market that they've entered. Well, they hope to change all that with this newest Tundra. As always, the Tundra shows quality in every detail, including the small but noticeable things like the damper-controlled tailgate, or the small camera in the tailgate that helps you not only watch for kids and dogs and toys before you back up, but, as we found out, it's also extremely useful for backing up to your trailer. Now, in the past, the cabin was a little bit on the simple side, but the newest Tundra has features like dual zone and bi-level climate controls adjustable for different temperatures at different levels. Now, there's also features like a center console that's set up to hold hanging files, or in the Crew Max cab, there's even a sliding and reclining rear seat. Although the Tundra still comes with the 271 horsepower 4.7 liter V8 standard, there's a 381 horsepower 5.7 liter V8 optional. Now, the 5.7 liter V8 comes with a 6-speed automatic, and the 4.7 comes with a 5-speed automatic. The C-channel frame has been boxed and strengthened for more rigidity on rough roads and when fully loaded. Now, the biggest differences, though, between the old Tundra and the new one can be found in dimensions and capacities. The new Tundra can carry 1,585 pounds on its bed compared to 1,500 for the old one. But the big difference is that the new Tundra can tow 10,100 pounds of trailer compared to 6,500 pounds with the old Tundra. Now, it also weighs more, 5,630 pounds compared to 5,020 pounds for the old. The good quality materials, plenty of power for towing, a well laid out interior, and details like that dampened tailgate and the backup camera, and an off switch for the traction control. The bad? Steep price, huge traffic blocking side mirrors, a little too softly sprung for serious towing duties, and a very over invasive traction control system. And what's up with those door handles off a Nissan Pathfinder? The bottom line, although a great truck for a lot of uses, until there's an HD model with a long bed and a diesel, I think the big three American truck companies are still going to own the real truck market.
Are you driving around in a naked rhino? Well, strong up and ride. It's easy with a full line of great products by J. Strong Industries. Windshields, doors, consoles, bumpers, battery isolators, and even tops complete with lights and stereo systems. J. Strong products are designed to work and constructed with only the highest quality materials. Ask for J. Strong products at your local dealer or visit their website to find a dealer near you. J. Strong Industries. Strong up and ride.
If you want more information on the products, ATVs, or adventures featured in today's show, make sure you check out our website at atvtv.com.